Hey guys, and what's going on? It's Magz, and today I have a longer MOAB for you guys. It's going to be a support MOAB where I'm only running the UAV and Ballistic Vests. At the beginning of this game, I made the terrible mistake of choosing my Search and Destroy class, and how I set up my Search and Destroy class is I don't really play Search that much, but I use Recon Pro, I believe it's Assassin Pro, Dead Silence Pro, and I'm using an MP7 with extended mags and silencer. I know, it's such a great gun, whatever. But beyond that, I think I'm using MP9 for secondary. But I messed up when I picked this class, and I've already died, I think once. I died once in this game. And I decided to go ahead and pick this class again because I was like, you know, it doesn't hurt. I'm just goofing off, whatever. And then, you know, I'm playing around, I get a couple kills in, and I realize, hey, I really could get a support MOAB running only UAVs and only Ballistic Vests. And I got lucky on this one because nobody was running Assassin. I think there was only like one or two people running Assassin, but there was like a ton of really crappy snipers on the other team. They weren't really trying very hard, and I mean, from the spawn on, we had trapped them in C. And it's very possible, this map is Arcadin. If you guys know how to do this, which most of you do, I don't have to go through this, lots of other people do, but the main trap that you want on this map is always going to be C-spawn. It's just impossible to get out of there. If you got people watching top mall, if you got people watching Broken or Crash, some people call that Crash, and IKEA or the furniture shop, then you've pretty much got them set back in that spawn, and as long as you got someone surfing around A, making sure they're not flipping or anything, you've got it locked down, and these kids will not leave the spawn. So it's super easy mode. That's all you need to know. And here's another thing. A lot of people who get MOABs on YouTube usually have teams that set them up for success. You know, you look at the UAV or look at the HUD, and you guys can see UAV after UAV after UAV after UAV. Well, in this particular match, I was putting up all the UAVs. You'll notice how many UAVs I put up and ballistic vests I put out and how many people grab the vest and actually use the UAVs to their advantage. So I'm running full support for myself. There has never been a MOAB where I put up that other people run support for me. We're all slayers. We all try to play our game to the best, and we want the W. That's what it's all about. That's what the game should be about, right? Objective, you want the W? Whatever. But beyond this whole thing, I've just spent too much time talking about this. I really wanted to get into a separate topic that I thought was super huge, but I'm really poor. I am, and I don't mean destitute poor. I mean poor, like, there's not a lot of things that I can purchase on my own right now. I really do have to rely on budgeting and trying to make things work. But I've recently been watching the news, and everyone's been talking about those three people that won the Mega Millions, you know, that $500 million in prize money. That's exactly what they won, $500 million. Now, they'll probably only see about a quarter of it due to like taxes and everything, and then splitting it down the middle, so it's even less, but each one should get, you know, a proper amount of money. And depending on how they spend it is how they'll see fit to where, you know, where it goes. Because you see horror stories of how millionaires win and then they, you know, do drugs and they go out and they buy like the dumbest shit. Like I watched a show today that, you know, when someone wins big, they have to replay all these lottery shows. So I watched a reality show on lottery winners today, and there was one where this lady, she like enjoyed living in her redneck style. So instead of, you know, buying a nice house, she just expanded her double wide. Like that's what she did. And that's cool. You know, that's totally on you. You do you. Whatever it takes for you to pay your bills and to not rely on the government and other taxpayers, then that's totally fine too. However, you know, how I would spend my money is completely different. And I know it seems kind of stupid, but every time someone wins a lottery, I always think about how, if I won, how would I spend my money? What would I do? And, well, for starters, I would actually want to invest a large portion of it. And if not a large portion, a decent portion of that money. Because how you make money is by spending money. You have to spend it to make it. So the proper thing to do is to invest a good portion of it so you can live off that money in some type of way. I know not a lot of people think that because you think you win tons of money. I'm going to buy myself a fucking Maserati, you know. And I wish I were more like that if I had, like, a gajillion dollars, but I don't have it in me to do that. Actually, I thought about the first thing that I would purchase if I won the Mega Millions, and I know it seems like really stupid to everybody. But the first thing that I would purchase is a fuel efficient car. Everyone who wins the lottery always buys a car. You know, and you got to buy the fastest shit out there. But I would definitely just want a fuel efficient car because I'm very conservative, you know, and I've budgeted so much throughout my entire life that keeping money where it needs to be, which is in my pocket, is actually in my best financial and stable interest. And, you know, let me know what you guys think about winning the lottery and what you would guys do. Because I would definitely still keep going to school, but I would, you know, transfer to a school that I would like to go to, because there are other schools that I want to go to that cost much more money, you know. And I would enjoy having a career as well as, you know, all this money to spend and go do stuff like, you know, invest in charities and companies and stuff to keep the cash flow kind of to where it's at. So I take a really smart approach, but let me know in the comments section what you guys would do. Anyways, that's the end of the gameplay. I'm Magz. Peace.